In this tutorial, we will be showing how you can dictate the flow of your workflow process from form created using Joget Form Builder. You can also see on how we can write form field value into a workflow processes variable. We will be doing it over the sample app, the HR expenses claim app that you can find in your Joget installation as well as from the Joget marketplace. We are going to study the workflow process design of this app. This is the App Designer console for HR Expenses Claim app. Click on Processes. Click on Process. In this workflow design, we can see that there are two routes. For any routing to be made, the decision on routing must be made before the route. For the first route, Approve Claim Activity Form seems to be the likely activity where the decision is to be made. Let's inspect the form that is tied to this activity. HR Expense Approval Form is the form tied to it. Open it up in the Form Builder. Look for the element that is likely to influence the decision making. The select box looks to be the one. Edit it. We can see that the options offered here actually match what's in the workflow design. Let's compare and see three options, three possible routes. Now, it is very important to note that this is just an ordinary form element up to this point. It does not in any way will affect the outcome of the workflow unless. Go to the second tab. Look for workflow variable. This is where we map the form value to workflow variable. On submission of this form, the value selected in the select box will be written into the workflow variable, which happens to be of the same name, status. Now, let's go back to the process builder. We will show you on how we created the transitions. Edit one of the transitions with conditions. This is how the condition is fulfilled, using this expression. Take note that the expression is written in JavaScript. Make sure that you comply with its syntax. Or, we can also make use of the condition helper to define it easily. Done. Now, let's us demonstrate on how it works in runtime. Create a new claim. Go through the flow process until we reach approved claim. Select Resubmit and Approval. Complete it. It goes to where we want it to be. Let's inspect the process monitoring. The activity trail is correct as well. Click into Approve Claim. We can see that the value is set correctly too. That's it. This is how we can map form field value to workflow variable of the workflow process. In this case, we use the workflow variable value to dictate the flow of our process. Thank you for watching.